Hello there, ladies, gentlemen, and unicorns. Welcome to another stream and congratulations to Lady Misleaf and Frank on the pop quiz. You're really nailing this. I should come up with a bunch of new questions. So, yes, how are you doing, everyone? I'm doing great. I'm celebrating in my lockdown. Today it's the 5th of December and tradition has it that Saint Nicholas, this one here, I already ate the top part of him, is going from door to door with his trusty ally, the Krampus, you probably heard of this, and I already saw some Krampus running around today, which is weird because we're all under lockdown, but apparently evil never sleeps. Sound, is it just you, Remco? Okay. Thank you, Lady Misleaf. It's good that at least, this was one of those streams where I thought, I'm already late, so I probably don't have to check my setup. And I'm very much looking forward to technical difficulties. Speaking of which, I already got the first draft of a technical difficulties card set up. Here's a sneak peek. So yeah, there will be some elevator music and maybe some unicorns doing the drawing and so on. So I have some ideas for this. But I hope you get the sound done, Remco. I don't know how this works, but I hope you can hear me. Or at least if you watch the VOD. Hey, Remco, I hope you can hear me. All right, what's in store for us today? I thought I'd just continue working on my little game prototype. That is, if you recall from last time or the time before that, essentially it's an HTML5 Twine game that I want to bring onto Steam. And you know me, I just am going crazy with polishing. And last time, TikTok. Nice. And last time I thought, if you remember, we tried different color schemes for the Steam headers on the store page, and I was really not sure whether to go with blue background or green background, and I think I have things sorted out, so I'm eager to show you. Lady Misleaf said, if it makes you feel better, we lost our hot water on my Monday stream. Oh no! So that got interrupted and I burned myself on Friday stream, so it all evens out. No, you know what, just in the middle, there's the sweet spot between burning yourself and no hot water, which means I couldn't focus on code for a while. Oh dear, this sounds dire. I hope you're fine now. Talking about things that are neither one thing nor the other, but they work, statistically is, I already told this story probably when people told me, yeah, you should really get Final Fantasy VII. It's the best game ever since sliced bread. Yeah, this is a saying we have here, the best thing since sliced bread. And I went to the local store and of course they wouldn't carry Final Fantasy VII because it was sold out. But I saw there Final Fantasy VI and Final Fantasy VIII. And I thought, if I buy them both, I get two sevens. So must be that good. So yeah, it was a different experience, but I've never finished a Final Fantasy game. Never ever, because I'm one of those people who just go in willy-nilly, just blank slate, and with some games I have to crunch, other games where I say, don't level up, the monsters level with you, and others are where I completely misconfigured my character or didn't understand a certain element of the mechanics. Either way, I've never finished a Final Fantasy game, but Maybe one day. So, Lady Misleaf says, our hot water was fixed 2 hours later and my thumb is now a little blistered but painless. Blistered but painless. Which reminds me of Ludum Dare. So, the next one is Ludum Dare 50, if I recall correctly. And I have a certain idea of what I want to do with this very special, wonderful round number. But I don't want to jinx it, especially because I don't know if I have anything ready by then. But yeah, maybe that is going to be a little bit differently. Fingers crossed that, yeah, as starting from Ludum Dare 50, maybe 51, pretty sure 51, there will be some changes. I hope you will like them. Anyway, Frank says, making tea is dangerous. Coffee is as much as... depends. Depends. I mean, I had this French coffee press, and I think I put scalding water not once, not twice, but at least three times over my head because I was so eager to fill up the coffee. And of course, I didn't have my coffee yet, and this is why I was a bit uncoordinated. Right, let me switch over. Hi, it's me again in small. This is, I think here is where the action is going to happen. Yeah, this is what Lady Mistily found out. Yeah, of course. I mean, I have this tendency to burn myself or injure myself with a lot of things. I mean, I always joke that usually people dislocate their shoulder when they are fighting a mighty dragon. I dislocate my shoulder when I'm trying to scratch an itch on my back. and it's only slightly exaggerated. Our Lady Mist Leaf says, I burned myself tipping the hot water dispenser to get the small amount of additional water I needed to top up my tea. Oh, it's always, if you go in for this last thing, everything worked out, and then maybe just one more. and didn't notice the burning vent until my thumb burned. Ah, ouch. Okay, so at least you're on the side of recovery, which is good. So I tip my St. Nicholas in your honor. It's dark chocolate. I'm not a big fan of dark chocolate, but I mean chocolate. What's wrong with chocolate? And I mean, I get the appeal of dark chocolate, but personally, I'm just this milk chocolate guy. But I have to be super, super cautious when I'm eating milk chocolate, because if I can't take just one bite, I have to eat the entire tablet and then the other one. Right. Let's have a sip of water, because we all want to stay hydrated. Your first burn ever! My God, welcome to the wonderful world of minor injuries, heat-related injuries. But aloe vera, yeah, this is, I think, the best thing against burns. I also use it when having sunburns. It really calms the skin. So yeah, that's quite good. And of course, as my granny always said, and put if you burn yourself somewhere, just put it under running ice cold water. And you're good. That's my granny. Though, I have to be fair, she's already dead. So maybe it's not the best advice nowadays. Lady Mistleaf said, I like my chocolate sweet, so the best dark chocolate I eat is orange dark chocolate. Oh God, I know orange dark chocolate. This is a great choice for dark chocolate. I think we got some oranges. Maybe I can somehow mesh them up. But it's already Christmas cookies time. And my wife tried today doing some Christmas cookies, and she tried a new recipe, and it didn't work out. It looked wonderful before you put it in the oven, and like 5 minutes later, everything was super flat and started to burn. But it smelled wonderfully, because she pulled it out before it burned, and it tasted wonderful, but it was just a flat layer of butter and sugar. Which brings us to video games, right? Okay, so to bring you up to speed, what I want to do, or still am in the process of doing, is bringing my Twine game over to Steam, and I have a lot of ideas of how to expand it. So if you played Power MT, the Ludum Dare game, it's probably it will probably feel like just a short thing, a demo essentially for Power MT, the Steam game, because I had so many ideas. And there is a shout out from my side for a wonderful little program, a little program that I have on my telephone. I sound like a boomer right now. I have this little app, I think that's what the youth calls it. And the app is called Novelist, and it doesn't cost a thing, and it's for Android, at least I got the Android version. The cool thing is you can set your own categories, you can set your writing goals, you can even write on your phone, and I'm using it, I mean, you really can't see much there, everything is super bright. Anyway, maybe I can get it on the screen just to show you. Wonderful, yeah. Let me try to get my phone screen on the stream screen. Stream screen, say this three times in a row and don't scream. Lady Miss Liv says, if anyone reads Frank's comment and thinks it sounds mean, he's only saying this because he was on my stream as my burn went from that was unpleasant to ow, cane hurts a little too, how can a thumb hurt so much? And he proceeded to give first aid advice and was unaware of. What the hell did Frank said? I kind of wish you'd been burned before. You'd have known how to treat it early then. Okay, yeah, it comes off mean, but as we all know, Frank, when something comes off as mean, he's either making a joke or you're misreading things, because Frank is such a nice person. So thank you, Frank, for giving first aid advice across the big pond. get my phone onto the stream. Where do I have it? Scrippy, there it is, and I think it should work, but it does not. Okay, so apparently it's not working. I will try once again. ADB push returned value 1. Failed to get device unauthorized. Really? Is this device not yet authorized? Or is it just not properly connected? Because this could be the problem. There we go. Let's try this once more. Essentially, what I'm trying to run is Scrippy, Scrypy. That's a little tool to run essentially just mirror any Android device onto the screen, but apparently it's not working for some reason. Usually I mean I've already unlocked my phone for this kind of thing, but yeah, it's not working. Rest assured, so the app is called Novelist. Of course, it's mostly for writing, but again, I found it super helpful when trying to organize a text game, at least. So, yeah, wanted to show you something, but it doesn't work. Automated Unicorn says, Frank doesn't have a mean bone in Sparkle Sparkle. I don't think you do. In Sparkle Sparkle. Right, so what has changed with my game since the last time? Like I said, I wasn't sure with this blue header image that we had, because I felt that the blue and the green was a bit clashing. Let me show you what I mean, because I always felt that the main menu wasn't looking this nice. So that we have this green bluish tint here and this dark blue there in the background. For some reason, it didn't feel coherent, nice or anything. It just felt a bit, that it doesn't belong. So what I always say, if you feel like two colors are too closely related, either overlap them or pull them further apart, so that it looks intentional. I think this is true across the board. For example, if you're doing a photograph and you're just slightly tilted, it looks like, yeah, was this intentional or not? You can tell. But if you go like this, so really like 45 degrees angle, you can always say that was intentional, because it doesn't look like a mistake. And same thing with colors. If your colors are too closely related, or there are many clashing colors, and it's, even if it's intentional, it doesn't look intentional. And so what I thought with this is make everything green. And what I, of course, then realized is what works well with green is, of course, a warm orange, a friendly orange. And so this, let me show you. I started just before a render job, and it has already finished. Where is it? Assets, videos, conversion out. There is a new converted menu, and this is what it looks like now. So we have everything is green, as you can see now, and there is this cone of a flashlight to really bring across the idea of it's a moody horror game. But and also I fixed the incorrect loop point. Before, there was something that was a bit wrong. Anyway, so what I want to do now is to test this out with the actual main menu, which I haven't had time to. So this is, was one of the reasons to get this, while the stream was delayed a bit today, was because I want to automate this video conversion thingy. Because I'm doing those background videos with After Effects, and maybe there will be more than one background video. And so the thing is, I render everything out as ProRes, Apple ProRes 4444. This is an industry standard for super high quality video. It's not losslessly compressed, but closely, almost lossless compression. Problem is 30 seconds here, if you can see this, it's 1.03 gigabytes. So this is, of course, too much. So, and now I have here this a conversion script that converts ProRes to WebM. And I can say here, yeah, the bitrate is 8 megabits per second. The width, because sometimes maybe I have it smaller or bigger, and I want just to specify the width and the frame rate, which is 60 FPS. And then it just goes through. I can even specify, is it with sound or without sound? So either one or zero. And from that, everything in this folder gets automatically at the highest quality settings transcoded over to WebM. This is just a test file. So, and now it's 30 megabytes and looks gorgeous. Because you know me, I'm a quality nerd, and it always bugs me when something could be better but is not. So yeah, this is my shortcoming. And Bolto is here. Thank you so much for dropping by, Bolto. Right, so where do I put my new assets? They go into the build sources, and there is MOVs, and there is title menu animation. And yeah, this is the old version, which is the blue one without the cone. So I think I can just delete and replace it. There we go. So I have here my build script. I've already touched what my build script does. Probably I should disable my Dropbox now, because my work folders are all in my Dropbox. So if it's constantly syncing while I'm just updating files there, it's no fun. Okay, so this is, let's go full screen then. This is what it looks now. And now I realized that the blue color there on the buttons, if I zoom in, so the buttons have this dark blue color because everything was then dark blue. But yeah, this is, I like this actually much better. So if it's now with this green tint instead of the blue one. So let me catch up with the chat. I'm not entirely sure Automated Unicorn is trying to say about me, Frank said, about the sparkle. Automated Unicorn just loves to sparkle. I mean, trying to show a phone screen on the stream does feel a bit like you want to use your new technical difficulty screen. Yeah, I'm tempting fate here. But yeah, it didn't work out. Sounds about right. And thank you for feeding the Automated Unicorn. And I need to go bio, and winter is whining, so I'll be back in a few. Yeah, thank you so much for dropping by, and probably you've already returned. Maybe. When I've caught up with the chat. What works well with green is orange, and what works well with orange is dark chocolate. Well said, Frank. Well said. And Bolto thinks it looks great. Thank you so much, Bolto. So I probably will, I mean, for now it doesn't matter much that the buttons are bluish, but maybe I want to change this. Do the credits already work? Yeah, everything is using the correct background, which I like very much. Cool. I've started a settings menu. This is a settings menu. And yeah, I wanted to add some settings for different volume settings, essentially, for music, sound effects, and ambience. Turns out audio is a nightmare with JavaScript. I really tried to get started with it, but I just realized I had 1.5 hours of time in between of one of my jobs at work, and I thought, yeah, this is just perfect to try things out, just get an understanding and then implement it. It took me 1.5 hours to wrap my head around the audio API for web. And the thing is, there is already a library. It's called Howl or Howler. Bad thing is, it doesn't work with something that is static, that just thinks it's running in a web browser. Because the problem is that I have is I'm getting a lot of cores warnings. For those who don't know what the hell am I talking about with cores, is this is essentially is a security measure from the browser, especially with HTML5, where you have a canvas where you want to draw something, and then suddenly your website accesses local files, which means the canvas is now tainted and you can't read from it, because otherwise it would be possible to just read a file from someone's hard drive, draw it onto a canvas, and then read out and then have the file essentially transferred to yourself or whatever. You could do some nefarious things there. The problem is, I mean, this all makes sense, of course, if it's on the web or something and you as a user don't know if the true intentions of a website. But if you're doing game development, and I really want to access just local files, because I mean, the game itself thinks it is a website, but essentially it's just running all the assets locally from this folder, right? So this is the problem that I'm having also with audio, because if you want to do something that's a bit more elaborate than just play something and have a play bar or a scrub bar, I'm getting those course warnings. And like I said, there is this Howler library, but it doesn't really work. I get weird error messages with NW.js. So yeah, I still don't have quite figured out how to do things. I think, was it here, my settings HTML file? I think I put in some... I don't think I have it here. Essentially, I even have it here in my entry file. In my comments, I think I have a reference to a... Was it Greenheart Games? No, not this one. Somewhere. Fades, bounce, minimize, full screen buttons. Somewhere in there, there is something to do with audio, but it was not here, I think. Frank says, course is something I fully understand while reading an explanation of it, but which I'm utterly confused as soon as I look away from the explanation. Yeah, same thing happens to me at the end. The explanation it doesn't really help when you're trying to do certain practical things. For example, I wanted to essentially program for myself something that's akin to a vector scope. So just to quickly illustrate what this looks like, have this program here that is just called scopes, and if it starts, does it run? It does not run. Let me try it again. Apparently it's not, doesn't want to run. So essentially a vector scope, as I want to see a video vector scope, essentially just is a circle, and it just plots all the pixel values, the color values of the pixels you have in an image, in a circular fashion, like much like the color wheel that you have in many graphics programs, right? And all I wanted to do is get a bunch of images and plot all their pixels onto this vector scope. And it didn't work because I'm accessing local files in an automated fashion, because I don't want to specify each time, yeah, please, those are the files that I want. I just want to pop it into a folder and run it through, and this is the average color, for example, of those images. And it didn't work because, yeah, the images were local and I was plotting onto a canvas, but then I couldn't access the pixels in the canvas. So, yeah. And Lady Misleaf is back. Course is horrible. It's cross-origin reference exceptions or something. It's, yeah, when websites, when you have JavaScript and you want to access local files and then do something with the data from the local files, and all the browsers, of course, are prohibiting it because it's a huge security risk. But of course, if you want to do some game development and all you have is local files and you don't want to stream them from some web browser, because it doesn't have to be if you distribute your game via Steam, everything is in the assets folder. So yeah, this is the problem that I'm having. And Frank says, CORS stands for cross-origin resource sharing. There we go. And it's a thing that tries to protect people by regulating which JavaScript can access which resources. For example, JavaScript can access images that come from the same service as the JavaScript comes from, but everything else is suspect. Exactly, yeah. Wonderfully put, thank you. Right, and I had this, as I just explained, with images, and then I angrily tweeted about why I hate CORS so much and how is there a way to deactivate it or say something. Yet I'm running locally, so this is not an issue, and I had to give up. And I thought, yeah, that's that. Then a couple of weeks later, I tried to do audio with my game and with HTML5, and I realized I'm having the same problems all over again. So it's not working what I want to do. Right, so what do I want to do right now? Because I'm all over the place today, so I apologize for that. Right, so let me run here the title in the browser, and it's working with the correct background, which is good, but I wanted, right, I wanted to change the JavaScript that's displaying here the buttons, right? So I've compartmentalized my JavaScript, so it should be, I think it should be in the UI. So I have here my styles folder, and there is root GUI buttons, title, general style. I think it's, is it in the GUI buttons? Window close buttons. To explain what the GUI buttons are, they are, right now they don't show up here because, of course, this is a website, so I can't quit a website. All it does is just issues an event up the chain where it says, yeah, please quit me. So the actual game is in this folder. So the GUI buttons are these buttons here at the top, and as soon as I zoom in, they disappear. So these buttons are the GUI buttons. So this is not the CSS that I want to tackle. Let's have a look at the console, and there, yeah, Howler. There we go. Howler is this open source, I think. At least it's a free open library that essentially should handle all your audio needs. But there we just get a reference error that Howler Global is not defined, and I mean it's in line 3224, and I haven't written this thing, and it works when you're running it in the browser but not in NW.js. So yeah, who knows what the problem is. So essentially it all comes down to, yeah, I'm coding my own. Right, so this was not the source of the buttons, but I think it's under general styles or just title GUI. There we go, title GUI. Where's my folder? Where's my... Okay, apparently I have to open a new explorer there. Make a bit more room. Right, assets. No, it's not assets. It's build sources styles, and they're title GUI. There we go. Right, UI button, and there essentially we get corner color. So right now let's pick some nice colors. I have here this little tool which is called Visual Color Picker, and I love it to death because you can just move around and then pick the color, and you can even specify in what you get even this little zoom thing here, and you can even specify in what format you want it output. For example, you can even say when you're doing things like, I don't know, a game maker stuff, you can have it printed in the format that game maker accepts for creating a color. So that's super nice. So what do I want the corner color to be? So I just take, maybe, yeah, let's just take the green here from the title. So border is this color here, and the text color is, I mean, it's a shade of blue. So let's make this a shade of green. So again, I pick the same color, but make it just ever so slightly that it's just a little bit greenish. Or what's happening when I'm hover over it? Yeah, it gets this color. So when I'm hovering something, I want it also to be as green, maybe as the title sign. Maybe a bit brighter even. I mean, it's not really green. Essentially, it's aqua. And right, the background color. Yeah, I need something that's super dark green. It's even darker green here than the background. Maybe something like this. Copy and paste. And there we go. And if I reload this, why don't I see this reflected? Title. Am I running the correct file here? Title. Yes, now it works. So now everything here is green, and when I hit maybe credits, I can't switch to credits now, because the problem is whenever, I mean, those are links, but whenever I click something here, it doesn't change the page by itself. It just tells the encasing, the carrier medium HTML page, because this is running in an iframe. It tells its parent, hey, there has been a change requested with a fade out and a fade in. Please handle it however you want to handle it. So I like how this is looking. I like how this is looking, actually. Cool. And the automated unicorn just called out some lurkers, so I'm really sorry that the automated unicorn is the automated unicorn. Right, so let's build it again and see if it actually works in NW.js. There it launches, and yeah, everything has here the new, and it's super laggy. My god, and also the background animation is probably not running at 60 FPS. Maybe it's because the stream is running, or because I'm constantly rendering an invisible canvas on top of everything. As I've said 2 weeks before, this is so that the Steam, should Steam be online, that it can draw over it. So if I go to credits, then everything should look nice. Also the credits. Yeah, and here the back to main menu button. Because I changed it in one CSS file, it's now changed in all the other pages that use it, which is exactly what I want. Oh yeah, and as you can see, it fades out and it fades in. So essentially, this is just the page carrying the iframe of the title menu or the credits page. On top, it just renders a solid, then it loads the new page in the background, and once it's loaded, it does the fade out. So I think that's pretty clever. And yeah, this is just a random or regular prompt from JavaScript. Okay, cool. So I'm dancing around the issue of sound and audio. So let's see if I can get this somehow working. So how do I handle audio? Let's have a look at JS. So there is this Howler.js thing running, which I meant or wanted to use for sound. And let's open the documentation for Howler so that you can read along. So Howler.js and GitHub, because it's like everything, it's on GitHub. Ew, jQuery, how dare you? I mean, I have it in there because I probably want to have some sliders in the main menu, and I don't feel like programming a slider. But apart from that, I'm not using jQuery because I'm in it for the fun of doing everything myself. I know everyone has their preferences. So where is Howler? Howler.js from Gluck Games. There we go. Right. So Howler is an audio library for the modern web. It defaults to web audio API and falls back to HTML5 audio. So yeah, it's super nice. There are a lot of yeah, you can download, I think, 223. This is also the one that I have. And it, yeah, just bounces you right back to GitHub. So essentially, it's as simple as you specify a sound, give it an array with different formats for different browsers, for example, MP3 or OGG or WebM, yeah, or WAV, and say autoplay, volume, something, something, and on end, you run another function. So it's essentially, it sounds like it's super, super simple and helpful, but again, it doesn't work. It doesn't work in WJS, but we could try again. Maybe I can find out what the actual problem is. Sparkle, and hello there, Commander Stitch. Thank you for dropping by. So I think I have Howler here in my Howler. Do I have it here, or am I initializing it somewhere else? UI events, macros, Steam. It's been a couple of days since I've last opened dispatch UI event to parent. It's been a couple of days since I had my project open, and it was enough to confuse me where I have my Howler. I think I have it here on the title screen where I tried it out. Yeah, there we go. Howler is the script that I'm running, and video source, main content. And right, so okay, there are all my URLs for reference, so to look things up. So essentially, I just say Howler, and then here new Howl, and it should play it, right? Because I have here also this requirement. This is because if it's running in a jQuery mode, essentially, if this is active, I think it should build and should run in NW.js, but it does not. But at least this was, let's have a look at the console, and there it says Howler global, yeah, again, is not defined, and we're not hearing any music or things. So this is bad. This is bad, but let's deactivate this once more. I mean, I'm loading here the correct script file. Save. I mean, we should hear something, right? If I'm running here the title. Oh, so many browser windows. Do I hear anything? I don't hear anything. Why don't I even hear anything? So it should run here something in music. I have here titlemusic.org, which is really just something that I just some temp music that I put in here. And I have even button click and button hover. Really? Apparently I have. And title ambience and title music. So ambience is here and the title music. So everything should run fine. So what I'm essentially saying here is, yeah, I think I've ripped out this Howler thing entirely, because I'm just here, ambience, whatever the current ambience is, play the ambience, whatever the current music is, play the music, and it does not do it. Uncode reference, yeah, it's not defined. There we have it. This is the problem. Cross origin request blocked, same origin policy disallows reading the remote resource of Dropbox ambience course request, not HTTP. I mean, there is a way around it, you could fake or run your own HTTP server and then route the calls to local files through it and put an HTTP header on the receiving file so that the JavaScript thinks it's getting something from a web server, but essentially it's just, yeah, I mean, it's a huge hassle and I don't want to do this, so there has to be something that's a bit easier. So HTML5 audio pool is exhausted, returning potentially locked audio object. Wonderful autoplay is only allowed when approved by the user. Yeah, this is another thing that you have to allow autoplay, and I think this is why it's not running. So let's try this again. Yeah, now it's working. But again, only locally. And yeah, this is problematic, and so I thought, I don't want to bother anymore with Howler. Instead, I want to look at this audio context and audio out. So this thing is, if you look at this, this looks much, much messier than it has to be. But let's have a look at Howler web audio. I think this is what is going to be my Bible. Dynamic music in games using web audio. I will paste this in the chat now if anyone is interested. Too long, don't read. Web audio is a solid API with many features. It's easy to create complex effects like pitching, panning, so essentially everything that you want to do with audio. A battle-proven wrapper like Howler.js that takes care of the details is definitely a thing to consider. I considered it, it didn't work. So essentially, this is a very fine blog article. It tells you, the new audio is a bit like HTML5 audio is a bit like, I mean, it's geared towards, you could write your own digital audio workstation in this thing, potentially. So it's saying, it's not like, yeah, this is a file, I want to play it, but you can say, okay, we got an audio context. We got various nodes that process things, various sources that read something from a buffer or from an array or, it was the same thing essentially. And then wire those things up, basically to different processors, and then put it to a destination, and the final destination, pun intended, is the sound card output, right? So here, for example, it looks already a bit involved, right? Maybe first we get the file that we want. It's in this case, it's an MP3. Then we decode it and store it in an audio buffer. This is going to be our source. And then we get some properties like we want to loop it, and the playback rate is 44,100 hertz. Then we connect this to a gain node, which has a parameter of just how high the volume is. Stick this to a stereo panner node. Do you want to have it left or right? And then we stick it to the final location that is the web audio, just the output. Everyone should write their own dog once, says Frank. Right, everyone should write their own game engine, everyone should write their own Linux core, and everyone should write their own DAW. Maybe should also write your own text editor, I think. At least a bad one. So there is a, I know already that iOS Safari does not support the stereo panner node. So if panning is required, I hope to be able to use to channel splitter node. So this is at least one of those things that I hopefully don't have to get into things because I'm running NW.js. But the problem is Safari is based on WebKit, and NW.js I think is also using WebKit. I'm not quite sure if they're WebKit or Chromium right now. But I think at least they started out with WebKit and they shared the same base as Safari. At least this is what I've heard. I'm no expert, you can clearly tell. Right, there it says, we need to decode an MP3 to an audio buffer and link it to an instance of audio buffer's source node. Then we connect it with the two processing nodes and the stereo panel using the parameter loop and so on. Lastly, we connect it to the destination so we can hear something. Right, which features I need for game dev? And yeah, being able to make use of heavily compressed file formats, this is important. Sound effects should play at low latency because you want them always to be there when you push something or when something happens. Sound effects should support panning, pitching, and gaining, which would be nice. At least one track background music should play with a low load on the CPU. I want two tracks, for example, one music track, one ambience track. And in the end, I came to think maybe two music tracks that I can fade music between tracks when they're running. Maybe also doing some fades between ambience, and maybe one sound effects track should not be enough. Maybe three sound effects tracks. So which essentially comes down to 7 or 8 audio tracks that I would need for my text game. Isn't this crazy? So what I really want, dynamic music system, and yeah, this is, I mean, a clever looping. Yeah, this is already something that's a bit too advanced for me. Multi-layer music. I thought I hope to be able to take out what I want from this little tutorial, but essentially it's prepare, create an audio context. So create an audio context. And then you just say, can it play? And the fun thing is, you just say, can it play audio MP3? Can it play all? Can it play wave? And the result is maybe, probably, and maybe. This is not something that you want when you ask a definitive question and have the console output. You want true or false, not maybe, probably, maybe. What? The browser cannot know because I don't get it. Anyway, so audio context experiment. And so this is, I think, what I want to try today. And which means I'm going to just copy it. Register events to actually enable sound playing. So mouse down, init true, add event listener. Okay, so I will just copy this as it is and try to see if I can get this working. So I will take out now my howler. Well, I'm not going to take out my howler. You know what? Maybe the volume I want to keep. You're probably wondering why I'm doing this with Notepad++ and not things like, VS Code. This is because what I started with, right? cool. Okay, so what we need is an audio context. So I just paste the code and then we go through it. So the global audio context in this case is null. And so, right, we create an audio context and is either, yeah, is it audio or WebKit audio? So this just chooses, is it WebKit or not WebKit? So this makes sense. So at the end here, we should have a global audio context. I will move this bit now. No, this is actually what I tried before. And we got a first time chat from something that, thank you, Frank. Thank you for wielding the old Ben hammer. I was all excited. Oh my God, there's someone new chatting, but yeah. But can it play Monkeys Audio and Wavepack? I have no idea what Monkeys Audio and Wavepack are. Right, okay, audio. So what does it do? So initializing the buffer, function init. And the function is, how long is the function? It goes until here. Enjoy using the API. Yeah, wonderful. Okay, so we create an audio context. And we got a source at the end. And we just fill it here with something. I mean, we don't even have a file here. We just create an empty buffer that is one sample all in size. So create, yeah, an empty fake buffer in the right sample rate. Play it once to make sure sample rate is set and sound is unmuted. And register events to actually enable sound playing. So the document when mouse down, we want to run init. When the touch gets started init, or when it's touched, we want to run init. Right, okay, so essentially just whenever something is the user is somehow interacting with the page, right? Okay, so can we get here a console log works question mark? This is my good old printf way of debugging. So this is so it makes sure that it's only going to run once. Yeah, let's build this entire thing and try it. And then we should know. So let's open a console and there we get, yeah, Howler global is not defined. And when I'm clicking something here, it just says assignment to constant variable init. So apparently init is running multiple times now because I'm getting this init title line 110 and line 110 is initted equals true. So apparently I should, initted is false here. So it should not be a constant. It should be a var, I think, right? So we have no global audio context. We got the sample rate and the empty buffer. Let's try this again. I have chocolate now on the floor. Wonderful. Okay, so we got at least a new message and it says here, the web audio autoplay policy will be re-enabled in Chrome 70. Please check that your website is compatible with it. So essentially, I think it's good. What we need now is, again, since this is running in a Chromium, I think, I mean, if it says here Chrome 70 and this looks like Chrome, yeah, then we should tell NW.js that essentially we want autoplay enabled. How do we do this? Let's have a look at the documentation. NW.js autoplay enabled. I have a feeling that it's just you put it in the manifest file. Autoplay. Oh, cool. Cool. It's an app crash, but it's from 3 years ago. And it's closed. This is good, so, but apparently it's not what I want. And WJS documentation. Maybe this will help us. So, autoplay. Wonderful. Enable autoplay Chrome. Yeah. How to enable video autoplay? Autoplay policy in Chrome can by using the command flag autoplay policy, no user gesture required. You know what? I will just try and use this in my manifest file. And where is the manifest file? It's package.json. So there we have Chromium args. And I think I should just add this to the Chromium arguments and run the game once and see if that has fixed it. And it says assignment to constant var. Okay, so this was. Okay, web audio autoplay policy will be re-enabled. Please check your website. Okay, so. Okay, so this is what the problem is causing, that I'm trying to set an audio context, but we already are don't have an autoplay thing in place. So I want to add those Chromium arguments now to this JSON package file. In my case, this package file gets created from my build script, so I have to do this here in the build script. This should happen somewhere here at the top. Create manifest. Chromium args. There we go. Autoplay policy. No user gesture required. Maybe that's already it. Cursey Bull says, does NWJS browser have a debug console and stuff you could use directly? Yeah, it's like a Chrome browser. You just hit, if you compile it with the SDK, as I'm doing, you just hit F12 and then you can look at what the actual problem is. It doesn't tell you a lot. Wait, does it say it will be re-enabled in 2018? Yes, the problem is I'm not using the most recent version of NWJS because I need to have the Steam integration, and this Steam integration is running, is using Greenworks, and Greenworks wants a very special version of NWJS and a very special version of the Steam SDK, and both aren't the most current one version, so I think this is why it's saying this. So, why is there a comma? Okay, of course, yeah, it makes sense that there is a comma. Disable transparency, disable REF autoplay policy, no user gesture required. So apparently this was not it. Yeah, oh fun, yes. Apparently I did not reload something. Anyway, let's not get distraught. I've dropped the ball now where I was, so I would just rebuild everything again and have another look at the console. So now it's running the game in NWJS. There we have it. Assignment to constant variable at line 112. And yeah, I'm assigning there a constant variable. And I'm still having here the web audio thingy here. That is, your website is compatible with it. So what I'm trying now is, right, I've regained what I wanted to try before. So it's in this entry file. There we go. So one thing is, was it in the entry file? Wait a second. No, it was not in the entry file. It was in the title file. There we go. So global audio context is, of course, a variable and not a constant, at least not while it's here, null. So, and I will just say it's window audio context and not WebKit audio context. So essentially, I'm just saying audio context is window audio context is my global audio context. And let's try this. I mean, it's a bit wasteful that I'm always building my thing from nothing, but create buffer is not a function at line 116. Debugging. I love it. So empty buffer global audio context is audio. It's new. How did I do this? Audio context is new audio context, and audio out is a new context destination. This is how I did it when I was trying, and I think this works better. So audio context, let's say audio CTX, and say audio CTX is new audio context. There we go. And there as a constant or const, and can exchange this global audio context for just audio CTX and hope for the best. Right. Okay. So let's try it like this here in the build sources. I'm just running it now in invalid assignment of to const in empty buffer. You know what? Those consts are really problematic. So I just will say, yeah, again, is it there? So source, that's a new const. Let's make this all variables unless, I mean, yeah. Let's make this all variables and see what the problem is. Okay, so now works, it says here works. So once I click first, then it says here works question mark, which is good. We're not hearing anything, but at least that's that's something. Ah, it's tiny incremental wins over something that's clearly hostile towards you. Okay, so let's have a look at this. And it says here works. But again, we have here this at line 114. This is where I'm just creating a new audio context. And it says here, the web audio autoplay policy will be re-enabled. Please check that your reps. Yeah, okay, but how can I? Anyway, players will be clicking in the game anyway, somehow. And then I have an audio context. So I think this should not be problematic. At least we can say works. Okay, so let's see what else I have here of my code. So I have an audio context and I have audio out. Audio out. So, right, I have, you know what, I will make this all vars, despite it would be better, of course, if there are consts, but just to make things easier for myself. So we get an audio context and an audio out. So I'm creating a new buffer source, which is also what I did here. And I create a new audio buffer. And I mean, this could all go into init. Init? So essentially, I will just try my own code here that I came up with, and then see if I can say works. So we got here gain node sound effects, gain node music, and gain node ambience. So we just create gain. And then, of course, I want to mix those together or decode data music, then decoded data, use the decoded data here. Let's just say console log use data here question mark and see what that does. Oh, I hate this so much. All I want to play is audio. This is, I mean, I really, really love JavaScript, but then there are certain things that make it super impossible. Okay, so we can say here, uncut reference CTX is not defined in 128. So we kill everything. 128 CTX decode audio data. Oh, it's audio CTX, the audio context. We want to decode the music data, which is sound music, and sound music is where does sound music happen? Okay, I don't even have sound music, so. Okay, documentation time. This is way over my head already. Okay, cool. So, audio context, decode audio data. Yeah, already had clicked this before. So the array buffer, the success callback, and the error callback. So did I copy something from here? Yeah, probably this entire thing here. On load, request response. My God, this is just so new promise-based syntax. Wonderful. This is apparently what I've used, the promise-based syntax. I don't know how promise-based syntax, what this means. Use the decoded data here. Ah, okay, so this is where I copied it from. Okay, so the audio data. Where is the audio data here? Audio context, I create a new audio context. Apparently this is how you do it. Pre, query selector, pre, script, play, stop. Oh my God. Use XHR, what the hell is XHR? To load an audio track and decode audio data to decode it and stick it in a buffer. Then we put the buffer into the source. Okay, so we get the data. The source is, we create a buffer source. I think this is what we did. We create a buffer source. And the buffer is the audio buffer, which is the buffer that we created. This is so confusing because everything is... Is it a source? Is it a buffer? What is it? In what direction does this go? Because it looks like it's circular. So Frank says, ooh, documentation. I was working with a thing a few weeks ago where the closest thing I found to documentation was a citationless statement on Stack Overflow that it's very well documented. Wonderful. I love those things. I mean, documentation is one thing. You see how much of a hard time I'm having even with documentation. Now imagine you're like in 1993 trying to develop something for the Super Nintendo and all you got is stacks of Japanese bad documentation and there was no internet. So the cool thing at least is with the internet, hopefully you're not the only one having a problem. And maybe you strike gold, but yeah, I know. Documentation is something, I mean, first world problems. Getting angry about documentation. At least I have documentation. where was I? Okay, let's have a look at this. So we create a new audio context. Check. Then we say pre. What's a query selector pre? I have no idea what this means. So we get the data. How do we get the data? So we get we open a new get request to get this org file and response type is an array buffer. So we request. Okay, an XHR is an XML HTTP request, I think. Right, so we request this file, and then what we get, we stick it into this array buffer. Or we want it as an array buffer. So on load, the audio data is, we request this thing here. So audio data, in this case, my audio data is sound music. So I will say sound music. Essentially, I want a decoded version of the org file, right? So, audio context decode audio data function buffer. Oh dear. Okay, so let's try this. Where do I put this with the? I mean, this is called just get data and then request send. My God. And there, okay, those are just the buttons. This is so super confusing. I don't really understand it. Okay, so the audio context, we want the decoded audio data, which is decoded sound music. This is what's happening here. And the function takes the buffer, which is the decoded data. So source, but the source is audio buffer source. Oh my God. Is it this, what am I doing here? So, okay, my God. This is so hard to understand. So base audio context decode audio data is a method of the base audio context interface that is used to asynchronously decode audio file data contained in an array buffer. In the case, the array buffer is loaded from HTTP request and file reader. In this case, and file reader, okay, where is it read from the file reader? File reader. Okay, file reader abort. File reader read as array buffer. Okay, I think this is what we want. Instance of file reader. Why? Oh my God, this object-oriented programming. Why does everything have to be an instance that you just want to use once for one thing and then you don't need it? Okay, I'm a little cloud. I see everything and then I just pass through. Instance of file reader read as array buffer and the blob is the file from which to read. Everything is supported here. The file reader interface is used to start reading the contents of a specified blob or file. When the read operation is finished, the ready state becomes done and the loaded is triggered. At that time, the result attribute contains an array buffer representing the file's data. I almost think that I can understand it. But yeah, thank you, Cursiboo. I really appreciate it. Not having fun here, but I only need to do this once I've wrapped my head around it. I think I can just use it and never touch code again. And I think this is all what we want as programmers, is you wrap your head around one complex thing and create this little package where you know, okay, I just stick this file in there and this is my output and I don't have to worry about what the hell is going on there, because you don't want to get into this thicket of dependencies. Oh, look at this. It has a little icon where you can copy it directly to your clipboard. This is super helpful. Okay. So first we need a new file reader, right? A file reader object. Let's web applications asynchronously read the contents of files or raw data buffer stored using file blob. Okay, is there an specifications. Is there an example? Okay, let's try this. Var file reader is new file reader. Then where was I before? Oh, this is so everything uses everything. Okay, file reader. Maybe I should start with a small f. File reader. Read as array buffer. Where's my music file? there it is. Music.org. And this is, of course, file API read as array buffer specifications. Yeah. Parameters. Is a method. Okay, is a method of the file. So does it return something? When the read operation is finished, the ready state becomes done. The file read is ready state? The ready state provides the current state of a file reader. Okay. So then we have to check if, for example, if file reader done or ready state is, what was the ready state? Loading done is 2. Console log empty, ready reader state will be 0. Yeah, done will be two. Onloaded function, console log done, reader ready state. I don't fully understand it. Number, which is one of the three possible. So if file ready state, file reader ready state is done, then console log file read correctly? Question mark. I mean, I'm aware that this is an asynchronous thing, and it's probably not in the next. It's probably not getting loaded within the next line of code, essentially. But I'm just trying to get something barely working. It's just really one baby step at a time. So the ready state becomes done, and the loaded is triggered. At that time, the result attribute, contains an array buffer. So once loaded is true, the result attribute loaded is triggered. My God, TikTok is going crazy. bubbles, no cancelable, no interface progress event. The loaded event is fired. Please show me an example. Reader add event listener. So reader is a new file reader. Oh dear. And onloaded. Load end, loaded, load end or loaded? Let's see this. Load end. Okay, so we create here a new file reader, right? And on this file reader, we add an event listener for load end, and this says just file loaded. For lack of a better thing. So essentially then we can say function, I mean we're right now in a function in here, so function file loaded. My God, this is oh, not fun. Yes, Mr. Julius, you may come in. I really hate this so much, and you can clearly see that I have no idea what I'm doing at this point. I don't understand it. Okay, where was I? Blob array buffer is a new promise. My God. Is a new promise-based API to read a file as an array buffer. So let's try this. Okay, buffer promise is, yeah, let's try this. Let's try this. I just paste it here and then go over it. So buffer promise is blob array buffer. Blob array buffer does something and then process the array buffer. And the buffer is a wait blob array buffer. All I want to play is to play audio on the title screen and be able for users to adjust volume. But I think I'm getting close to a point. I'm binging on chocolate now. I'm getting close to a point where I think, just screw this, you can't deactivate music in my game. You have to live with it. It's not going to be super expensive. You can't expect me to understand this crap here. I want an audio buffer that has my title music in there. Web design, exactly. Because, I mean, I would love that there would be a middleware that makes things easy for game developers, and apparently Howler.js is such a thing. But it's not working with NW.js, so I need to do things differently. Essentially just rolling my own things there. Dynamic music preparation. Yeah, this is, I'm so glad that you managed to get it to work, but I don't like this. We created and connected. So create a source, loaded audio buffer from somewhere. This is nice. How do you load your audio buffer from somewhere? You just create here an empty buffer. And the source is global create buffer source. So are you creating from a buffer and then it's a source, or are you creating a source that reads into a buffer? And again, I'm with the documentation. I'm utterly stumped. Right. So, I mean, since it's power empty, we should listen to Alan Wake soundtrack. Yeah, this would be nice. At least it's not a simple bean factory aware aspect instance factory. My God. I mean, all those promise-based things and so on. I mean, they look nice on paper because this is so much easier to write or cleaner. But now I got this await statement, and I have never worked with awaits before. So essentially, I mean, adding listeners to something, this is what I barely can comprehend. So the buffer awaits the blob array buffer. You know what? I'm going through this step by step. I will deactivate now this. Let's take out the blob. Yeah, sure. And I will deactivate now pretty much everything until here. Works, right. This is great. Got so much deactivated code here. So right now I'm just trying to see if I can read a file into a buffer. And probably, I have a hunch here that probably the problem is, yes, I can read a file into a buffer, but then I can't access said buffer because, of course, the cross-origin resource sharing exception, right? Game maker, Phil, come back to us to a warm and easy sounds management system. Exactly, yeah, this is what you get with engines, right? They are geared towards game development, and you know how to do sound. I mean, I'm not super happy with how sound is handled with Game Maker, but I didn't have to do anything complex with it yet. I mean, then of course there's middleware like WISE, and what was the other one? Fmod. Right, but this is also something that's a huge pain to implement if you're just one person. Essentially, you can do it in the code. You don't need to separate your audio person from your code. Right, but now with HTML5, as it is right now, it's just, I just don't get it. But it doesn't cost anything, right? It doesn't cost anything. So, the automated unicorn is drinking my coffee. How much worse can this get? Okay, so file reader read as array buffer. And then I will just console log file reader. Let's see what this does. Probably I won't even get to this point because I'll be having so many error messages up to this point. Okay, so let's drop it in this thing here and let's have a look here. File loaded is not defined. Where is file loaded? Oh, of course, I didn't have file loaded. And I'm already here in this init function anyway, which triggers once someone taps. It's a JS, right? Yeah, it's JavaScript, right? Yeah. So this init function runs, and once we're running, yeah, I take this out of the init function here. I'm just running it as it is. So I'm reading my title music file, right? And then it's function file loaded, and then it just says what the file reader's contents are. So let's try this. Uncaught type or error. File reader array is buffer. Argument one is not an object. Oh, of course. Read as array buffer. So you want a blob object, right? Oh dear. Oh dear, I hate this so much. Okay, so file reader documentation. File reader read as array buffer, right? Read as array buffer. Yeah, the contents of the specified blob. And we need first to get a blob of the file. Oh! The contents of a blob or a file. When I say a file, file to blob. Okay, using files from web applications for more information. Returns a newly constructed file. File objects are generally retrieved from a file list object or returned using the input operations data transfer or moz get as file from the HTML canvas element. A file object is a specific kind of a blob and can be used in any context. You know what throws me always off is that file goes to blob, but essentially, I mean, file is a type of blob. To me, it always feels that the blob should go to file. So it's like a tree structure. So this is always what's throwing me off. Anyway, it can be used in any context that a blob can. In particular, file reader, create URL, object URL, create image bitmap, XML HTTP request, accept in both blobs and files. Space Monkey says, welcome. Thank you, Space Monkey. I hate this so much. I have no idea clearly what I'm doing, so this is why I hate it. Did you know a horror game written in JavaScript is actually a pleonasm? Wait, what? That's something that's at odds with itself. Or no, wait. Pleonasm is if you're saying two things, the same thing with two different words. There we go. Something redundant. Thank you. it's like the bright sun or no, a shooting gun or something. I think. Literature. Right, so I want to get a file. Blob, prototype, slice stream, text. Array buffer. So file reader read as array buffer, and I need a file here first. So I can't just specify the file name. First, we need to create a file from this resource. So file bits. Oh God, an array buffer or a blob. No, I don't want to create a new file. I just want to read data and then store it into an array. Because something is okay, good. Wonderful. I'm just a happy little unicorn. Using files from web applications. File. Okay, do I have to specify the files first? Accessing files on a change event. Getting information about selected files. Example showing file sizes. Let's see, bytes, files, this files update size. Using hidden file input elements, using the click method, updating a label, selecting files using drag and drop. This is all very nice, but this is not what I want. Showing thumbnails of user selected images, using object URLs, Maybe is this what I want? When you have a file object you'd like to reference by URL from HTML, you can create an object URL like this. So, window URL, create object URL. Oh yeah, this is not... Or is this not what I want? And Skate888er redeemed unicorn. Thank you for redeeming it. I really need a sip of water right now. And you can't just do blah is new audio blah mp3 because of course. Right. Yeah, exactly. This would be the code I could use with Howler. I just say a new howl. This is my source. Autoplay, true buffer, true volume is of volume ambience. And there we go. But this doesn't work because of course, right? But maybe... I mean, this is all running in an iframe. Maybe I can say here in the documentation, maybe there is a way, sandbox, that I can deactivate this. Node and normal frames. Okay, node and normal frames. There are two kinds of frames in NW.js, node frames and normal frames. Node frames have following extra capabilities than normal, okay. So normal frames have not what node frames have. Okay, access node.js and the APIs. I don't need this access. extended DOM features such as save as dialog, user agent attribute, bypass all security restrictions such as sandboxing, same origin policy. Yes, this I think this is what I want. For example, you can make cross-origin XHR to any remote sites or access to iframe elements whose source points to remote sites in node frames. I think this is what I want. In NW.js, frames matching all of the following criteria will be a node frame. Okay, so I want a node frame. Node.js set to true in manifest file. Okay, I can do this. Let's try this. No, I don't. To save this title GUI entry package JSON. No. Oh, I already have it here. Node.js is true. Okay, I already have this. The URL of windows and frames matching node remote patterns in manifest file or Chrome extension protocol. What? Node remote. I already clicked this. This feature changed. Okay. Array or string enable calling node in remote pages. The value controls for these sites should be turned on. So a match pattern essentially is an URL that begins with a permitted scheme or FTP that can contain star characters. A special pattern all URLs matches any URLs that starts with the permitted scheme. Each match pattern has three parts. Is this a puzzle game? Scheme. Here's the basic syntax. Space Monkey says, is the problem that you can't load and play an audio file that's on the server from JS? Essentially, yes. Since I'm running my game inside NW.js from something that is called Howl, which is just this thing that should make it super easy to run. I've shown it here that essentially Howl is just this JavaScript library that you can use, and then you can just say a new Howl from this file and it should run, right? And it works mostly in the browser, but you know what, I will just take out all the other audio crap that I did. Console works. Where does this thing come from? I think we got here a stray. There we go. Okay, this is super bad, but I think when loaded. Googling gives me this cola. Oops, I mean, run Chrome without cores. Right click on desktop and this disable web security, disable user, disable web security. Yeah, let's try this. Let's try this flag. Maybe this is all we need, right? Maybe this is all we need. So right, when I'm building my, where is my build script? I just need to add this to the Chromium arguments. I'm not sure if this still works. Yeah, let's find out. Where is Chromium arguments? Oh dear. There we go. And I just add disable web security. Sure, why not? Let's try this. If this works, this would be something. Okay, I don't have audio because Howler Global is not defined and when loaded is not defined. Okay, I think I still need to clean up my title. I still need to clean up my title. So sound effects is new audio file. Event listener. Click, 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 version info. So right, I need to activate this, that Howler that is found. Close this and let's build again and try this again. Right. Remco says, Frank is right though, and you really have to make sure you only use it locally, not for the real web. Exactly, yeah, it's not intended for the real web. So when loaded is not defined, where does this come from? DOM content loaded. Oh yeah, I deleted this, but maybe I should put it back in. Because I'm not using this anymore, actually. Where is when loaded? When loaded, there we go. Function when loaded, do something. So yeah, essentially it should run Howler, right? And it works locally. I mean, maybe I should take it out here when I'm using it as require. Let's try this as well. Just want audio. Just want a simple way to run audio. So I'm not hearing any audio, so this is already bad. But I'm not getting any errors anymore. I also don't hear anything, but I'm not getting any errors anymore, which is quite good. So what's not happening here is current ambience play. So I will just say sound ambience new howl. I mean, when loaded, we should play the ambience and the music. Or don't I just hear it? But so far, I mean, I'm not getting any weird error messages, which is already, fingers crossed, already something. Yeah, not hearing any sound. Not hearing any sound sources. Are there any sources? Audio sources? No. I mean, or is this really just super quiet? No, it's not. I will decrease the volume now. right. Howler require howl, music ambience, sound ambience. And according to Howler, it should work like this. I mean, examples. Let's have a look at the examples. Audio sprites. Yeah, this is a cool thing from Howler. You can have one file with a lot of sound effects, and you just say at what time which sound effects plays, for example, for menus and so on, so that you don't have to have a myriad of little click sounds, just one file where they are all in succession. So live demos, audio player. Yeah, I don't want an audio player. All I want for Christmas is audio. So yeah, examples, new howl, sound equals this. So new sound ambience, we say this is the source. And then we say sound play. Sound ambience play. Streaming audio, more playback options, autoplay, volume, and so on and so forth. Sound music, cool. But yeah. Listen for events, sound once, load function, play clear listener after first call. Fires when the sound finishes playing, sound on play. Let's try this. Current aim or sound ambience on play function. Is this the right thing to make a new function in line? I always forget how this works. is a new function that just says console log should play right. This is how you make a new function inside another function that you only need once. I'm not quite sure. Remco says, first try the sound effects maybe, then you know whether it's Howler or something else. The sound effects, this new audio thing, I'm not quite sure whether audio is from Howler, essentially. Because for, I mean, this, all I'm doing is this Howler thingy to say new Howl, and this is what the Howler is. Space Monkey says, maybe I'm just really suspicious by nature, but I definitely try to print a log or something when in that when loaded function. Yeah, of course. Console log loaded question mark. This is always good. Yeah, always cover all your bases because you can never be sure that certain code already runs. And those printf debugging, it's like the core tenet of how I do game development is just print something to know that a certain loop has been triggered or whatevs. So F12 says here, unexpected token. So this is good? No, it's not good. And we also don't have the console, but probably because I have here. How do I say this is a new function and this is what the function is? I think this is how it works. Advanced debug systems, not just simple print and got your bag. Exactly, right? I mean, who needs a debugger anyway or a profiler or anything if you can just print something? So at least it did run. Yeah, let's try this again. I need to close my consoles because I always like to keep my consoles open with a pause command. So what do we have here? F12. Show me what you got. Loaded! There we go. Apparently we are in this loaded thing. But when I click it, it should just display the current time. Why does it display here the current time? Console log time when on mouse down function. Oh, right, yeah. This is still my old debugging thing. More stuff happening. My God, it's amazing. The internet, so many things are going on. So let's, yeah, thank you. Sound ambience on, oh, of course, it must be sound ambience 1. And sound ambience, current ambience. Oh no, that's current ambience on play. Yeah, right now I'm just randomly changing things and recompiling everything and trying it out. Right. Can't be too hard. It's so hard. So we're running. F12. Uncaught. Type error. Okay. On is not a function, right? Because it's current music. I mean, what is this even returning? What is this even returning? So let's just check if sound music on or once console log play once. Let's try this. Also, maybe place the hook before the play. I have no idea. Really experienced. Not really. Yeah. Oh, let's try this. Usually it should. I mean, since it's asynchronous, it should run. What do we have now? Okay. So I got a loaded, but not on play. So something was loaded, but it's not playing. So here we are. Right. Let's try this in this case. Or even maybe outside of the function. Music. Do I have your music? Yes. Okay, good. Yeah, let's try it like so. Sure, why not? I have no idea, yeah. Same. Also no idea. I'm not hearing anything. Which means, yeah. Doesn't really, I mean, It says you're loaded. So when loaded is running, but this when loaded is here from the DOM content. So essentially sound ambience, you know what? I will say just console log and say sound ambience. Please just log whatever sound ambience currently is. So learning JS together a Sunday night. That's what I call fun, not even ironically. Thank you for not calling this ironically. JavaScript, like I said, I like JavaScript for the most part, but things like this takes all the fun out. So what do we have here? What do we have here? Howl. There we go. So this is a howl. So apparently this was created. Look at this. The source is the ambience. State is loading. So maybe we should just say, okay, on loaded, then play it. And maybe this is the problem, that I tried to play it before it's loaded. It has a duration of 0. Wait, what? Duration 0. Yeah, probably maybe because it's still loading and it does not how long it is. So yeah, let's try and say on loaded, right? Music once loaded once. But now I have to really look at and see if this is actually the on function. So where is it? Core methods. Play, pause, stop, mute, volume, fade, seek, state. Check the load state of how returns loaded. Okay. But can't I say on loaded? There we go. On load. Load error, play error. Once event. Same as on, but it removes itself after the callback is fired. Okay, which is cool, essentially. Right, one on multiple events can be added by calling this multiple times. On load off. This is called by default, but if you set preload to false, you must call load. Okay, unload. Yeah, let's just say on load. So it's not loaded, just say on load. And then we say console log loaded once. And then we say sound music play. Is this play? Yeah, play. Like so. Okay, good. So essentially after the load, we should hear the music. So what does the fox say? What does the chat say? What a name like Howler. Maybe it only works when there's a full moon. Yeah, yes. and you need a silver bullet to stop it. Dread, it's a new moon today. Woohoo! Maybe we get this to work. Maybe if you had a button, you could run the code when everything is loaded more easily. Yeah, I think I could use one of the menu buttons for this, but I really wanted to load it like when you start something, but this would be my next thing then. Okay, I'm not hearing anything. This is bad. The howl is still here, and I need more print statements. So music once load. Console log loaded once. So apparently this is not even running or hasn't even run. So I'm just going to go here with sound music once load, then we say load once and say play, and on play it says should play, and when loaded, you know what, I will wait until the website is loaded. Or, yeah, the main menu is loaded, and then try this. Simple! My god. Moon object factory make blob. Oh my god, please don't make blobs. No sound, no problem. Loaded question mark, probably. The howl is still there. I mean, it's howling orientation. This is super nice. I mean, the volume is correct. The state is loading. I mean, I could check the state here once it's loaded. Sound, music, state. Was it the state? Console log. Sound, music, state, or is it a get state? I don't know. State. Loaded, unloaded, loading, or loaded state. Loaded. Set to true, autoplay, true. This is true. Sprite object, define the sound sprite. Oh, okay, those are sound sprites. This is not what I want. Okay, buffer it true, loaded true. Maybe if I buffer false, but this would be really, really weird. I'm really lacking some sort of meaningful feedback from Howler or pretty much anything there. What does it want of me? So loaded and it's loading. Okay, when we're still here, it's still loading. Music is still loading when it's loaded. At least when the page is loaded. Thank you, Automated Unicorn. So what I need essentially to do is, the fun thing is, I mean, it should use here this once sound music on load. Maybe I should put this right here. So once load, this load is really throwing me off. Load, because I want to say it has it loaded. On load function fires when the sound is loaded. Okay, so sound music on load. Just say loaded, play. Let's try this then. Maybe it's just super long to load because it's a big music file. I mean, it's running locally. It's not that big. It should run, get loaded actually quite quickly. So I don't understand it. Uncaught type error. Music on load is not a function. Is it not? Okay, so new howl. Oh, it's an XHR and only then it's dear. Why is this so? State check the load status of howl. So essentially I need to come up with my own loop and just look at whether something has finally loaded before I can play it. This doesn't make a lot of sense. So it sounds once load. I think this essentially is, it sounds once load, then please play, right? This can't be too hard now. So, right, so sound, let's say sound music once load, sound music play. And also say here, loaded, play. I hate this. Maybe check for load error. But how? I thought that Howler would maybe say something when loading doesn't work. How loaded loading, but apparently it still says here. Preload true. I want to preload this. State is loading. Method get, headers null with credentials false. Let's have a look more at the examples, right? This can't be too hard. Okay, I make this big so that you all can follow along what the examples are. So control multiple sounds, this would be nice. So we get here sound, ID sound play one, sound play two. But listen for events. Sound is a new howl sound, and once load, then the function is replayed. And fires when the sound finishes playing on end, say finished. Was there a on load error function? On load error. On load error fires when the sound is unable to load. Thank you. But this is only here with the HXR objects, I think. But let's try this. On load error, on play error, fires when the sound is unable to load. The first parameter of the ID is the sound, if it exists, and the second is the error message. One, the fetching process for the media resource was aborted by the user agent at the user's request. A network error, okay. Let's try this, but I'm not very hopeful. So, sound as a music on load error. Where, how do I say this? Okay, so those are core options. Sources, the volume. Is there an example where I can say on load error, is this a function that then should run console log, or can I just say console log and the load error? If there is a load error. Space Monkey says, well, we're making progress, and now we know that the sound is apparently not loading properly. I hope that that's the problem. Maybe it's just an ugly file name, and that's the problem. But the thing is, it worked before in the browser, not just in NW.js, how I did this the other way before. But yeah, let's see what comes of this. Oh, it does not run because I still have it there in the background. I need to close all my build scripts there. They're still running. So yeah, let's try this, the current version. And it says how loaded loading. And yeah, Steam API, Steam is not connected right now, but okay. You know what I want to try? Is now I want to try this in the browser. So for this I have to use undo and save, and doesn't have to use this, and then I can run it in the browser, and there at least the last time I had music. So this was here in my build sources and title. There we have music, right? There we have music. Sound music on load error is not a function. There we have it. Cross origin request blocked. There it says loaded loading should play. And it's working, right? It's just not working in NW.js, but here we have all the cross origin requests that are blocked there of the title ambience org and the title music. But nevertheless, it's trying some other way to get it. This is Howler, so I assume it does some magic, or maybe it just fakes a course request or HTML request. I don't know how it does it, but it works. And on load error is not a function. But yeah, this works. This works essentially. And if I'm not running here the script, but as a requirement, maybe if I put it up here, script, script. Oh dear. Maybe I need to put it into the header. Maybe that was the problem. I don't think that it was the problem, but have you tried running NW.js in administrator mode? I have this line pre-recorded when I answered the phone. I mean, I'm running it in SDK mode. So kinda, yes. I mean, I don't want administrator mode. I want it to run when users are running this game. And this is essentially what's doing here now, but I mean, what I could try is, you know what? I could try also not using the const, but just loading the script, right? And then we will see what's going on. I don't think I'm hearing anything. Yeah, Howler global is not defined. Howl is not defined. Cannot read property of state of undefined HTML document when loaded. Okay, so yeah, there is a bit more. What's not working? So at least we've established that we shouldn't do this. I mean, when it's here, then we can use Howler. Let me just try it again. That we at least have the howl object. Yes, there's a howl object, autoplay, but the duration again is zero and the state is loading. But everything else we've seen works. Muted is false, HTML5 is true, format is undefined, end timers, there's no end timer, but I think I have this feeling that we're very close. That we're very close to this. So console log sound music. I mean, when is this running? This is running right when the page loads. And once it's finished loading, then it runs here when loaded. So here we say when loaded, then when loaded, when the page is loaded, then let's say console log sound music again. Plus Remco plus plus says, I also vaguely recall struggling with relative paths in local mode. Does JS accept a leading dot as meaning the current directory? Yes, it does, because in Firefox and running it locally, it works. And this is also what I've used for other files. You can see here for my JavaScript macros and so on. So this clearly works. Otherwise, I wouldn't be seeing it, or it wouldn't register in the file. I would get errors if this did not work. So this clearly does work. Right. Yeah, it's just a stupid thing resulting in the sound not loading, like a wrong path. My gut feeling says it's a wrong path. But you know what? Let's try this. Let's try this then. So we're not doing Linux thing, but music. Maybe now that I've shuffled things around. Did I want to paste something? Music. Yeah, once loaded. I think I have it here. Sound music state. Once loaded, so I'm giving it here. Loaded play, sound music play. Yeah, let's sure. I'm a bit confused, right now, but let's try this. My God, I'm still surprised that apparently 12 viewers are watching. It can't all be my mom with this infuriating thing that is me trying to program while I'm in way over my head. But I have a feeling we're very close. No music. when loaded, okay, howl, there is the howl object again, and it's still loading. The source is now like so, but it's still not working. File system access path error if error console log file exists. I'm going to copy now what you wrote here. So I will just say unloaded and file system. I don't have a file system. What you want to do, says Gutierrez 007. Thank you so much for dropping by and and trying to mitigate my pain. Essentially, I'm just trying to get music playing in HTML5 because I want to control the volume and maybe even the panning, so it's not just something that where you can say, I'm just loading an audio file and be done with it. So this is why I'm using this howl middleware. It's just Howler.js. It's open source, and this should create for me all I need to do so that I don't have to worry about HTML5 audio, because this I tried half an hour ago and this is still the code that I commented out because I was hating it so much. And the more I tried to get to grips with it, the less I understood. And right now the problem is that I'm running this HTML5 page inside of NW.js. So essentially the page thinks it's running in a browser, but everything is local. And for that, I want to keep it running. Hi, Mom Pixel Prophecy. Thank you. Mom Prophecy. And Remco says, put it in a file that we know doesn't exist. See if the same thing happens. Oh, yeah, good idea. Let's essentially just say, I will recreate the path now. And just say title music something. Maybe then we get an error. So yeah, going the other way around, creating a file that clearly does not exist. And we got a syntax error. Oh my God, where is that happening? Oh yeah, of course, I just copy pasted your, thank you. I still need to create a file system object, and I hate object-oriented programming. I really hate it because I don't know why for everything, for every little managing thing, you need to create an object instance that just does one thing and then you destroy it again. And it's just so cumbersome, and you have like three classes to do one little thing that you could do procedurally. But anyway, okay, so what the problem is here? Okay, it does not say that there is a problem. It says here loading. And then we still have here loading. Okay, this is good. So thank you for helping me out on that. So it's essentially we're all still loading. So what I could try now is maybe I create a function that runs like 2 seconds after the page has loaded, which means after 2 seconds, we're going here from a local file. Essentially, it should be there, but apparently it's not there. And the automated unicorn, oh, it's so cute. It tries to help me. But it's after 5 seconds, it should not be loading anymore. So how did I do this? The callback. I always forget it. How to do this? Do I have here callback? So I just create a new, where do we have it? JS callback or callback hell. No, it's not a callback. It's a timer. Timing events, right. There it was. Set timeout and then my function, right. This is what I want to do. So timer is set timeout and function is console log or even, yeah, console log. No. Undo console log. Ding. Which should run after 2 seconds, and then essentially at this point, it should run whatever it was, right? I mean, if we loaded something, it should run after 2 seconds if we're running this locally. So I'm just trying to see if this ding thing works. There we go, ding, okay, good. Maybe give it 3 seconds. So after three seconds, I can say, yeah, now it should be loaded, if it exists. I mean, right now we know that it does not exist. I'm not even sure that this ding thing runs after 3 seconds after the page loads, so because it takes so long everything else to load. So let's give it like 5 seconds just to be sure. But apparently it's not loading anything. Okay, now I've fixed the path. Maybe that should work. I don't know. So after 5 seconds of launching, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, ding. That works, but it's not playing anything. It's not playing anything because it's forever loading. And I think we've established that for some reason, once it's running inside NW.js, it doesn't know where it is. I think you must play after loading, like video on load function. Yeah. I think the fun thing is that it works in Firefox if it's just an HTML file. But essentially, I mean, since I said it should preload, this is buffer, and it should autoplay. So essentially, once it's loaded, it should automatically play, and it doesn't. So it there shouldn't be. I mean, we get here console log on load error. This is not doing something here. Music once the music is loaded, it should do something. Like here, loaded play, but it is never loaded. And this is, I think, the problem. So we are here in when loaded. So, I'm Googling issues with NW.js and Howler, but I didn't find anything helpful so far. Thank you so much for Googling. Neither did I, but thank you. Again, I think what really helped was to disable this sandboxing to at least to get around the course exceptions, which is good. So thank you for that. So, yeah, again, I have a feeling that I'm very close. But something is not right. You know what? I will try now to take out this. Or is it in the wrong folder? Let me quickly check. So essentially we should be here. This is the title HTML. And it should look into music and ambience. So music, and there is title music org. It's in there. So as I was trying with dot slash, it's not working. Does it need the full path? I hope not. And I also tried, by the way, to play after loading, because once it's loaded, I said, let's play it. But I can try this again. Loaded, play. I don't think that this works, but if it does, hey, I take it. Okay, I need more chocolate now. Maybe if I switch off autoplay. And also say it's not buffering, who knows? Randomly changing values and hoping for different outcome. Peak programming. Ding, but yeah. I mean, it would have been nice. And muted true, I mean, I can show you again what this does. So if I disable now this part and enable Howler via JS and then run it in Firefox, it has music. It's not there. Here. I'm not sure if you can hear it, but it works, right? There's music. Same code, it just says here cross origin request blocked, but it says here loaded, play, should play, ding, should play. So we got it playing actually twice. But yeah, this is, it works in Firefox. Let's try it in Chrome. Let's try it in Chrome. Maybe there's a problem with Chrome. My God, why did I zoom into Google this far? Aha. So in Chrome, it does not work. Oh, I need to click it once because autoplay. But there it's also working. Howl when loaded, howl, fail to access resource music og. But now it's working. But it says here, net error, file not loaded. Okay, so XHTML request. So all these requests, I think, are just Howler trying various ways to get to the music. Audio pool exhausted, returning potentially locked audio object. Howler, yeah. Okay, I can't open this one. Build sources, title, ambience, your file could be accessed. File not found. I close this, or I mute at least here the tab now. Why can't I mute the tab? But I want to keep this open. Okay, so sorry. I mute now the desktop audio. Well, I hope I don't forget to unmute the desktop audio. Apparently sound should be MP with MP3, you mean, with NW.js? I mean, we could try this. So, but what's throwing me off here, it says that it doesn't find here the file that it's playing. I mean, in this case, it's not the ambience that's not playing, but here the title music. There it finds at least the title music, but the ambience, why does it not find the ambience? Ambience, title, ambience. Okay, at least there's something. It's not very loud, so I think I can just leave it on. Yeah, never mind. At least we know that out of the box, it also works with desktop audio back on. Okay, good. Desktop audio is back on, and also my speakers are unmuted. Right, okay, so let's try MP3. Let's try MP3. And there was something wrong. Ah, I called it here ambience, and there ambience. I don't know which one is correct, frankly. Ambience. 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 Ambience and ambience are both correct spellings of the same word. Are you freaking kidding me? Okay, so I don't. Okay, I've written here twice with A, so let's also go here with A because it's the first letter in the alphabet, and there it's also written with an A. Good. Okay, so let's make MP3s out of it. Sure, why not? Title music. Yes, export as MP3. Doesn't matter which compression I use. Are you present? Where did I put it? Ah, title music MP3. Okay, good. Is it actually music in there? Let's just test. Sorry, I'm swallowing words now. Foobar is on the foobar end of my screens, but yeah, the MP3 file is in fact working and correct. The title music MP3. My God, if that solves it, fingers crossed. Oh, right, of course. Yeah, now we're in NW.js. I need to do the old switcheroo. Enable this here and disable this one. I've grown really fast at commenting things out recently. Insisting on MP3 does seem weird. I mean, it is, right? I mean, everything is open on the web. But then again, it's Google. Yeah, it doesn't work either way. So no, Howl Music MP3, but it says loading. Always loading, never succeeding. Okay, let's try, well, not a different approach, but let's just have a closer look at the README file. Maybe there is something in there. Because I'm not quite sure that I have overlooked everything. Browser compatibility, Google Chrome, Firefox, Safari, even Microsoft Edge, you shouldn't have. Okay, or at least we can cross that. At least, yeah, you never know. I mean, sometimes even it's the most outlandish thing. You never know. You know what? We could leave both in even, because this is essentially what also Howler supports, that I can specify an array of different things. Gutierrez says, hey, and what's requiremusic.org? Requiremusic.org. Let me find, where do I have require this thing here, because this is the only require that I have. This one is when it's running inside of NW.js, that essentially, I mean, those are the same JavaScript thingies, but for one thing I need a require because the script doesn't work, and when I'm running it in a browser, only the script work because it works, because it doesn't know what a require is, because this is, I think, a Node.js thingy. Either way, I mean, something works. Okay, I try now things differently and make it super, super simple. I just create var sound music and just say it's a new Howl. And all it says is source is the source. And I just give it here the source and everything else. Volume, autoplay, pretty much everything, I don't care. Maybe this works, if it's just super basic and it was just a configuration error on my end. I'm the first to blame myself, but other people are quicker. Apparently it was not it. The Howl is end timer, muted false, loop false, HTML5 true. On end, on fade, on load, length 1, proto array, concat, copy with infill. Okay, so this is a string, I think. So on load, there is something on load error here, on mute. So I try now to find this on load error. Maybe. We learned something new. Okay, so apparently this was not it. So sound music on load error function console log load error. And yes, let's see if that does something. If you want image in Node, import image URL from images rocket.png. I don't know what you mean by that. I, again, all the other images and pretty much everything else is working from the local directory. So, ding, load error. Yeah, look at this. Now we get here at least a load error. Okay, so finally, I managed to get the right syntax, at least to have it tell me that there was a load error. It would be awfully nice to tell me what kind of load error, but if I recall correctly, on load error, we get here the error code. Fires when the sound is unable to load. The first parameter is the ID of the sound, if it exists, and the second is the error message code. Okay, then on load error, where do I have it? I mean, this is something. There's a load error of some kind. That's it. I'm downloading NW.js. I'm so sorry, Space Monkey. Do you want to know which version I'm running? because, like I said, it's not the newest version. Let me quickly find this out for you, so that yeah, that you don't even that we're not even far apart in terms of NW.js version. So let me quickly check. And the NW.js version that I'm running is 0.33.3, if that helps. Print the load error, so much suspense. Exactly. Suspense is killing me, and so is this entire experience. So where was my load error? On load error, sound music log. Load error. Is this correct? Is this the parameter that I... Or you know what? I will just log the entire sound music and then we have a look at what the actual thing is. Right, so I just console log load error. Then we know that the next one, the next object we get is the one we want to look into. Right, Remco++ or maybe two arguments should be in the docs. Yeah, again, if I pass the entire object, then somewhere there should be the problem, right? Load error. Okay, so let's have a look at what the load error is. Pool 5, Q 2, rate 1, event play. So I tried it to play it three times and it didn't work. So end timer is format undefined, HTML loop true, muted false, state still loading. And was it here in the XHR, I think somewhere. So toString, no, this is just a proto. Same thing here. Can I look for error somewhere? Not really. No, I mean in your own function. I just thought if I pass here the entire object, it would tell me when there is an onload error or an error function. Let me quickly check here. Onload error. There it says length 1, 0, proto there. Okay, so this is just the handle to the function, right? Name, constructor, prototype F. Yeah, this is just the function. Yeah, let's quit this. Okay, so you mean to my function that there I should print the load error. I'm not quite sure how to print the load error because the documentation doesn't really tell me there. Fires when the sound is unable to load. The first parameter is the ID. How do I get to this parameter of the ID? Do you have an idea? The error callback probably can be function error. Oh, you mean console log that I can just say function E. You mean like this? Error. And then we get this one here. Maybe, yeah. Okay, cool. Let's try this. It's two. Then we get this error object. Okay, right, this could work. Thank you. Error 1006. Cool. But this is not what I wanted, actually. Or is it? You know what? I just put it into its own log statement, then we can be absolutely sure that we get the right thing. But thank you. Inch by inch, slowly, I'm creeping towards what the root of the problem is. I hope. I really hope. So, call us in. Oh dear, what did I miss? 99. Oh yeah, it's semicolon, not colon. Thank you, JavaScript. As helpful as always. And build everything again. My God, my poor SSD. Probably, I mean, I could be mining some crypto instead of doing this, and it would not be as text as it is right now. Okay, so I just said error and didn't get to the error, but we had 1,006, which clearly was not in the documentation. So console log E. Let's try just here. But it said it had two. Oh, you know what? It had two. There. The first parameter is the ID of the sound, and this was maybe 1,006, and the second is the error message code. Okay, so error code defined in the spec. I click defined in the spec, and there we got. Okay, so this one is aborted is 1, network is 2, decode error is 3, or source not supported is 4. Beautiful. Doesn't really help. Okay, so the first parameter is the ID of the sound, and the second parameter, so it's an array maybe that we get back. I don't know. And this maybe 1 and this 0. My God. Then function sound ID error. So let's call EF. Let's try this. E and F. Yeah, thanks. I mean, you start out and I want to make a game and give me 2 hours and it's, I just want to know what the error actually is. Just give me a number. We don't get anything at this point. We were luckier before, I think. I mean, I don't even get the blob here of sound music, which is kind of weird. Yes, the howler is set here. I mean, it doesn't even run here when loaded. Clearly, there is something super wrong here. So function ef, console log e, console log f. There is something fishy here. It doesn't even give me correct error codes anymore. But you know what? Maybe console log e. I will try just console log e again. Did I close everything? Yeah. Maybe I should take out that it should not open the folder each time it runs. It compiles. So, okay, I don't even get an error message. I don't even get through to this. There is something wrong here before. Because I have a feeling when I comment out this line there and recompile it, then maybe it should be working. I mean, working, relatively speaking, that we get all the other errors. Not even those. How is this possible? How is... okay. Okay, one step back. What I want now is here in my build script. The first thing that I do is that I don't open the folder anymore and that I don't pause the script, that it just closes itself. Okay, so that's out of my hair. Then here we are in title, and let me open the folder in Explorer that I'm in the correct folder. So it's twine build sources. Okay, good. So I'm in the build sources folder. What else is open here in the background? Nothing. This is super odd. So the more I do, the less works. So Gutierrez says constant URL require path to music source URL. Okay, so you mean that I should make this a constant variable then? And should try this. Let's try this. Const music URL is music mp3 or music.org, doesn't really matter. And then I use music URL. And let's hope that this works. Okay, so when loaded, when does when loaded fire? When the entire thing is loaded, and after 5 seconds, it should do this ding thing here. So music when loaded. So it tried what we've seen before. It tried 3 times to play itself. So I will take this out and take this out and just have it here once. Okay, let's try this. Okay, I'm not getting my error messages anyway. Oh, require. You mean require. There we go. And this should give me an error message. I'm not quite sure what this does, but let's try it. I mean, if it works, it works. There we go. Invalid or unexpected token in my new script, create script. Holy, yeah, this is the require. Helpers cannot read property play of undefined. I don't think that this did help, but thanks. I had it working when it was like this before, right? Not like this. So then the function when loaded does not run. Music. Okay, did I change something here? Music. It's the new howl. Then there is the source, mp3 or og or whatever. Autoplay, loop and buffer is true. The volume is of volume music. Then when loaded, I create a new timer, but it never runs this when loaded for some reason again. Did I change something up here? No, it just required the howler. I build this again and hope for a different outcome, which will not happen. No. No new error messages, nothing. I don't get it. I really don't get it. So what if I take out the entire howler thing? Like so. Then it probably will complain that there is no sound ambience existing, but at least I would get different error messages. Okay, I have music playing in NW.js, but not using howler. Why are you using howler? That I can change, have users change the volume of different tracks, and then I can use multi-layer audio, essentially. This is why I want to use that, because before I had just the good old audio media object, and that worked as well, but I want to use a howler or something that I can dynamically change, for example, panning and volume and filtering and so on, in case I need it. Right, okay, so sound music not defined. This is good, so at least we know that it runs until line 108, but it did not log when loaded. It feels like suddenly it completely gave up. Oh, look at this. I think it is because I have here a filter on. I think this is the this was the problem that I had here, the filter on. Filter. Sweet. Okay. back to load error. There we go. Function E and F, and then we log E and F. Let's try this. Frank says, I think I'm going to go to sleep. Good night, and I hope you get things working. Thank you so much. And yeah, have a great night, and thank you for sticking with me for such long. This must be have been aggravating. And Gutierrez, redeemed unicorn. I have to drink water now. Thank you so much. Look at this. Isn't this beautiful? Isn't this beautiful? So this is the ID of the audio file, and this is the error code that we have. And error code 4, if I recall correctly, was it was of the wrong format. Yeah, source not supported. So the media resource assigned media provider object was not suitable to create a media error, blah, 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 whose message error code must be the empty string. Okay, good. So we know that, where was it? The media resource indicated by the source attribute or assigned media provider object was not suitable. What is a not suitable error? Okay, can I format? So there, maybe this is the thing that I can say format WebM or MP3. Let's try this. This is, and I think with that, I'm going to call it a night. But yeah. But hey, at least a success. We get more error messages now. Unexpected identifier, volume, the good old comma. Jason, everyone. Thank you, Automated Unicorn, for updating your wish list. It's almost Christmas and I don't know what I should get the Automated Unicorn. Probably, I don't know, some time off. Okay, so we still have 4 here. So apparently there is still something wrong and we don't know what is wrong with the format. So we have here MP4, WebM and MP3. So Dolby Audio Playback, full support for playback of the Dolby Audio format currently supported in Edge and Safari is included. However, you must specify that the file you're loading is Dolby since it is in the MP4 container. Okay, yeah, but we said here the first one is OGG MP. Maybe that's it. Maybe stumbles on the dash in the file names. I mean, it worked before in Chrome, right? I still think that it has to do something with not accepting local files. You know what? I could try. Maybe if I get a different error when I take out this one flag where do I have it? Sorry. Builds, there we go. Steam dev build, and they're in package.json. I've heard this disable web security. When I delete disable web security and run the game, then I hope I get some coarse errors, and maybe this is part of the problem. No, I do not, so this was not the problem at all, apparently. So let's try other things. Package.json. When I disable Node.js, does this change things? I'm grasping at straws here. Yes, so am I. Maybe it stumbles on dash in the file names. Yeah, again, I don't think it's the file names. So you know what? I will load now here the title in Firefox. And of course, this does not work because now Firefox says it doesn't know what a howl is because require is not defined because, yeah, it's that does not work. But I mean, I'm now here in the compiled thing. Now I get back to my sources and open the title again here with Firefox. And yeah, of course, it does not work. because of this thing here. If I load it now with Firefox, we should hear something. We have ambience and music as is. So I think the file names work. Let me try the same thing now with Chrome again. Where's my folder? I mean, this is super fun trying things out with you. Okay. Here in Chrome, it does not work. Oh, it does work. But it tried many things until it got to a point where it's working and we don't have the ambience audio. Because it says your HTML5 audio pool exhausted, returning potentially locked audio object. So if I refresh. Ding. Okay, there with the ding, after 5 seconds, it runs the audio. So it can't all be wrong. There is something with NW.js. So what's the ding doing? Right, it says here with ding, music play. But it did not play the ambience. So this autoplay did not work. But when I say music and ambience, then it probably should play after 3 seconds in Google as well with the ambience. Whereas my, there we go. Yeah, we have the ambience after 5 seconds and the audio. So at least after 5 seconds, something happens in Chrome. Despite shouting at me, various bad uncaught references, failed to load resource, access to XML HTTP request from origin null has been blocked by course policy, cross-origin requests are supported for protocol schemes, data Chrome extension, untrusted HTTPS, and so on and so forth. A Chrome untrusted, you know what? Let me just quickly Google Chrome untrusted. Maybe we can use this as in the file name is a scheme I can, because maybe if I say, yeah, it's, I know it's untrusted, but it's access a technical and semantic boundary between fully trusted web UIs and untrusted. Chrome untrusted, a separate media app, and Chrome untrusted media app. Okay. Chrome is too powerful to process untrustworthy content. Let's just Google for local. Okay, file. So untrusted content, so yeah, okay. So some parts are working in Chrome and in Firefox, but not in NW.js. This probably has to do something with how I'm initializing things here. Okay, so it's shortly after midnight and I have to go to sleep soon, but it's super hard when to call it quits. It says here ding, but I don't hear anything. We still got here this 4 as error code. We got here the correct formats. Got here the source, the first source, it says OG is loading. Okay, the last thing that I will try is switch the source formats. Space Monkey says, if nothing works, you can still upload an URL file to Steam. Also, it's bedtime. Yeah, but I don't want to upload something. All I want to do is to have this stored locally and then load it locally because it's super quick. And when it's from your hard drive and you don't have to be online or anything, it's just. Okay, on load error, so we're having load errors, right? I'm joking about the URL, of course. Oh, I thought this is a thing that you can actually dump files on Steam, right? I mean, I could essentially park this on my custom on my personal server, and I don't think that I would have as many players to DDoS myself. But then, of course, it would need to be downloaded. Base64 embed everything. Yeah, let's call this Plan B. But oh my god, oh, the files would just be, oh, the automated unicorn pooped the rainbow, which means, yeah, it's almost 3 hours that I've been streaming, or that the automated unicorn is running. Okay, so load error, mp3. I just use the mp3 file. But I think it has to do with sandboxing, with this course thing. And it doesn't tell me what exactly is the problem, just that the format is bad. Whatever bad means. But at least the background looks nice. And thanks for feeding the unicorn. Now that it pooped the rainbow, it needs to eat something. Okay, when loaded, sound... console log sound music timer set timeout, play music, play ambience, sound ambience on load error, please log the load errors. I think we should get now 1006 and 1005 or 1007 in the error message. Yeah, it's 1005 and 1006. Okay, good. So it has a problem with pretty much all the files. I mean, what I could try really now is just to upload it somewhere on the web, like I said, on my server somewhere, and see if it loads from the web for some weird reason. I mean, this would be... At least then we would know that it has to do with course. So title music MP3. I just stick it in there. So it's HTTPS pixel prophecy title music MP3. Now I'm curious. And that works. So again, I think it has to do with this sandboxing thing, because now I only get the error for the ambience. I mean, this would be the least favorable thing for me to do, is to just have all my audio somewhere on the web and then have it constantly loading from my server. But I mean, this is what we have Steam for, right? So again, I think it's a problem. Yeah, I will quit this now. I've learned that it's a problem somewhere, that it just doesn't like where I parked the music locally. Music, because this it doesn't like. Maybe let's say file music. Okay, yeah, I'm grasping at straws now. But okay, we know that when I upload the music to the web, it does work. This does not work. File or Chrome. Let's I don't know. I'm just trying random schemes here, in the hopes to get around the actual underlying issue. But I don't think that I do get around the issue. Oh well. Is it actually under music? Yes, okay, this is at least is correct. just sparkle in Firefox, sparkle in Chrome for everything, but sparkle audio doesn't work. Okay, just develop in Firefox, check in Chrome for everything, but assume audio doesn't work. Yeah, plan B. The baby woke up, so I stopped trying just to, so you know. Oh, it's okay. Thank you so much for trying this. You clearly don't have to. I mean, I'm even grateful for all the 11 viewers that are still out there just having me ramble and despair in one of their long lost tabs. And I think with that, I will call it a night. Okay, to sum up, I've implemented the new background animation for the title screen. How did I manage to do this? I just replaced the file, so this was easy. I did the CSS, the colors for the buttons. This was also not a problem. And now trying to get Howl to work with NW.js. And this is my Mount Everest, at least for the week that's ahead of us. So it was really fun, though. It's basically pair program. Yeah, thank you so much for everyone who really tried to help and double check what I was doing and suggested some things. And I mean, it worked, right? I'm a bit further down the road where I was before. Still don't know if I can delete this just yet, this big block of green horror. But yeah, you know what? Usually I forget to rate some other channel, but I think if we're all in the programming mood right now, maybe, you know what, let's see if I can find Twitch, someone who's also currently doing development, and then we can rate this wonderful person. I just say JavaScript, and maybe put the voice down. So JavaScript coding guru. Software and game development. This looks nice. What I mean, or does any one of you have certain people to follow? Look at this. Jim Sterling is streaming with 300. I mean, it's like Monster Hunt, but without all the everything. Dauntless. Okay, this sounds actually kind of fun, I have to say. Power Up with Pride is also running right now. Power Up with Pride. This sounds nice. Power Up with Pride. Thanks for the shoutout. Winter Pride, Metroid Zero Mission. Oh, this is such a great game. You know what? Yeah, let's. And yeah, thank you so much, Space Monkey, for dropping by. And yeah, let's. I cross my fingers that the baby gets to sleep soon, and that you also catch some sleep today. But thank you so much for sticking with me. Right. Okay. So let's rate then. Power Up with Pride. Then rate. Power Up with Pride. There we go. Okay, thank you so much and have a great night, and I see you next week. So, cheers. Oh, I can click rate now. This is super nice. Okay, so have a great week, and again, thank you for help.